follow Mary, trying to make sense of what happened to her, what happened to all of us because of what happened to her. Imagine Mary, probably a teenager, with no particular plans for her life, other than being a faithful wife to her friend Joseph the carpenter. And then she gets this announcement out of the blue. An angel comes to her and hails her. Hail, Mary. Mary says, "Why do you speak to me like that?" And the angel responds, "You will never be forgotten, Mary. As long as the earth exists, the story, your story, will be told. The story of all of the promises that God had made to your ancestors for literally thousands of years. Those promises were coming to fulfillment in and through you, little girl." Mary had free will, like we all do. Mary could have said, "You've got the wrong person, Lord. Or you've got the wrong person, Gabriel. I don't have what it takes to bear the Messiah, the Christ, into the world. I'm just a young woman." And the angel said to Mary, what angels always say, "Don't be afraid. God is with you. God has chosen you to fulfill God's promises through all these generations. And because of you and the child that you will bear, the whole world is different. A world that was dominated by darkness, by hatred, by evil, and by sin. That world is about to be overcome by love, by peace, by forgiveness. And you, Mary, you are blessed to be the bearer of the Messiah. Imagine the faith and even the courage that it took for Mary to say, let it be according to God's will. I am your servant, Lord. For the next 30 years, Mary watched the baby that she bore, this miraculous child, watched him grow into a man. Experience his leaving home gathering a new family around him, not excluding his old family, but other men and women who would be brought into the family of God's people, with Mary a part of that community. And as we know, Mary would one day sit at the foot of the cross and watch her beloved child be executed. She must have had feelings of despair, of abandonment, of hopelessness. But 3 days later, she saw her son alive again. She was able to see where the holes of the nails in his hands and his feet were. She knew that that was her son, Jesus, now alive. And now truly everything was different. Death no longer had power over creation. Evil and sin had been defeated. And so you ask, why does it seem as if sin and evil and darkness still are gathered all around us? The truth is, the reality is, that it is taking a very long time for the good news that is for all people to reach to all people. The truth is that you and I are called on, just as Mary was, you and I are called on to bear Christ into a broken world. All of us learn from that young Mary. Learn to hear God's promises, to believe that God will be faithful to God's promises, and to let our lives be used in the fulfillment of God's promises, so that we become good news to others. We bear Christ to others. One of the reasons Mary, the mother of our Lord, has for 2,000 years been honored in the church is because of her willingness to let her life be radically changed, radically disrupted, in order that God's will could be done through her. Discipleship is not about taking the easy road. It's not about just having some kind of private, personal relationship with God that has no public part to it. Discipleship is recognizing and believing God's promises, and then dedicating oneself to being, at least in some small way, the expression of God's love, hope, forgiveness, reconciliation. Mary has for generations has been seen as a symbol of the church itself. Just like Mary bore Jesus in her womb, the church bears Jesus in our community and carries that good news to the ends of the earth, starting right here in Rolling Meadows for us and rippling out to everywhere and to everyone who needs to hear that God is loving and faithful and just. This morning we give thanks for Mary, the mother of our Lord. And we also give thanks for our own mothers. And for those of you who are mothers, giving thanks for the opportunity, the challenges, all of the things that go into being a good mother. Today we celebrate Mary, the mother of our Lord. We celebrate all mothers. We celebrate our mothers. We give thanks. We give thanks today and every day that in God's will, in God's wisdom, God sent His Son to be among us. And the Spirit of Jesus still empowers us, fills us with His presence. In a few moments, we'll be invited to come forward and receive just a tiny bit of bread, just a sip of wine, and miraculously receive the Christ, the Messiah, the one through whom the whole world is made. We receive Him into our own bodies. He becomes a part of us. So when we leave this place, we carry Christ with us wherever we go. In God's faithfulness. Amen.